Hi, this is Guthrie Govan here. Just throwing a couple of tips at you with regard to string bending, which is one of the most fun things you can do on a guitar. It's a great way of taunting the piano players of the world. They can't bend strings, we can. We have an extra layer of expression in our playing. And in order to make the most of it, I think it's good to explore just what you can do with basic string bending technique. So what I'm going to suggest here is for any scale shape you know, explore every possible bend. So if, for instance, you're playing blues in E, and it's a guilty pleasure we're all guilty of from time to time, you might try, instead of just using the bends everyone knows and loves, you might assume that every single every single finger within that position has a bend assigned to it, and your goal would be to teach yourself how much each correct bend hurts. So let's start here with the lowest note. Now, if you're going to start bending that note up, you shouldn't really stop until it reaches the next note in the scale. Similarly, this note, if you want to bend it up, you should keep going until it sounds like the next note up in the scale, this one. And so on. So after a few possible misfires, you should start to develop a memory for how much each bend hurts, and roughly what it looks like and feels like. You'll note there, when I'm bending the first finger notes in the scale, rather than ripping off my first fingertip, being a martyr in the name of blues, I'm sneaking down and using those two fingers. Just because my fingers will last longer that way. I don't think anyone would really thank me for doing it just with my first finger. So use whatever works, as many fingers as you like, really. The idea is to get them all sounding as in tune as possible. Then you could apply the same thing to a seven note scale, one of the diatonic scales, maybe a mode of a major scale. I don't know, how about B Dorian, just for the fun of it. So for that, and so on. And if you really want to test your memory, a good thing to do is to fire up a backing track or something in the appropriate key. And then try and play all those bends in reverse. So you start with the bent pitch and then let it down and see if it still sounds good. Okay, and if you really want to have some fun, you could try that with the chromatic scale. Because the intervals are smaller there, the chromatic scale, of course, is just this one. Perhaps best known as a miserable picking exercise. It's also the flight of the bumblebee scale. It's just the one with every note in it. Because the jumps there are only a semitone in width, you should be able to bend to more than one different pitch per fret. So you could try maybe, so if you experiment with some of that stuff, it should open up some new bending possibilities in your playing, so that you feel like you've got more options for any given note you may find yourself having landed on. Happy bending, don't injure yourselves. Bye for now.